Hi everybody, it's Ingrid from Twinkle, and today I'm going to be talking you through the Eatwell guide and the five main food groups. To do this, we're going to be looking through this Eatwell guide PowerPoint by Twinkle. If you don't know, the Eatwell guide shows us how much of each food group we should eat every day in order to stay healthy. This is a good general guide to stick to in order to maintain a well-balanced diet. So let's take a look at it now. Here are our five food groups. We're going to go through each of these in more detail in a second, but first of all, let's just talk about some of the other bits of information on this slide. You may notice this little graphic here from foods that you may buy in the supermarket. This is there to give you information about what's in the food. Try to keep to your recommended daily intake for these things. This graphic should have a percentage for each of them to tell you how much of that daily allowance is in that food. Here we can see that the sugars section is in red, which means that this item is high in sugar. If it was in green, that would mean that the sugar content was low, and if it were in amber, it would mean that it was in between, and this goes for all of these. If we look over here, we can see that sugary and fatty snack foods should be eaten less often in smaller amounts. Now let's take a look at the food groups. As you can see, some of them are taking up a lot more space on this plate, and that's because we should be eating a lot more of some kinds of food than others. Let's take a look at each food group in more detail. First on the list is the fruits and vegetables. Fruits and vegetables are what we should be eating most of. Examples of these include apples, oranges, broccoli, and carrots. They include vitamins and minerals which help keep us healthy, as well as lots of fiber. People used to aim for about 5 portions of fruit and vegetables a day, but now doctors recommend that we try to eat at least 7. Another tip is to try eating fruits and vegetables of different colors so that you can get the benefits that come from different types. Next on the list is the carbohydrates. These are foods like bread, pasta, and potatoes. Carbohydrates are nutrients which give our bodies energy and fiber. You should try to aim for about 3 to 5 portions of carbohydrates a day, and it's better to aim for whole grain or high fiber options wherever possible, and those that are low in added fats, sugars, and salts. Thirdly, we have the proteins. This includes foods like beans, pulses, fish, and meat. Protein is a nutrient which is important to help us grow and help our bodies to repair themselves. These foods also have something called iron in them, which helps to keep our blood healthy. Fourth on the list is dairy. Milk, yogurt, and cheese are all examples of dairy. Dairy foods have lots of calcium in them, which is a nutrient that gives us healthy teeth and bones. A tip for dairy is to try to avoid the options that are high in fat and sugar. Finally, the smallest of the food groups is the oils and the spreads. These are the foods that we should have the least of in our diet because too much of them can be bad for our hearts. Some examples of these foods could be butter, margarine, cooking oils, and even mayonnaise if it's too oily. Now those are the 5 food groups, but before we go, let's talk quickly about the liquids that we should be drinking. According to the Eatwell guide, about 6 to 8 glasses of water a day is ideal, which can also extend to other sugar-free drink options. But drinks that are high in sugar should really be limited to about 150 mils every day. And those are our 5 food groups. If you'd like to download this PowerPoint to use yourself, you can do so via the Twinkle website. Thank you so much for watching and have a lovely day.